And we are live again for this daily Elastic Observability session. So today we are going to speak about ECS. If you remember the session from Alex on Monday, he spoke about adding a Java library on top of the project, which was a logback ECS encoder. And this library was basically generating JSON document for logs, but it was also applying ECS format. So what is ECS actually? So ECS stands for the Elastic Common Schema. So this is an open source specification, which is available on GitHub, and there is also the reference guide. We will see that in a moment. So what was the problem we have to solve? When you want to query your data set in Elasticsearch, and this data set is coming from multiple sources, it can be multiple Bits agent, it can be Logstash, it can be in your own application. When you want to search, for example, for the source address of an IP, you can end up with a query like this one, where you have to search within multiple fields because it depends on the index you are searching in. Instead of that, if you can use a common specification, then you can be sure that if you search in the source.ip field, then you will find the information that you are looking for. That would be much easier to build your queries. So that's why we built ECS. In the ECS specification, you will find information like this one, for example. The host specification basically contains all the information about the host. And if you drill down to the host IP, you will see that there is this specification here. It can contain an array of values. Those are IP addresses. But one of the important things that you can see here is that the type, which means the Elasticsearch type, is actually also set within the specification. So you are sure that when you are going to look at values within the host.ip field, it will be an IP address in the Elasticsearch way. So let's see all that in action. So I have here all the non-internal indices that we have in our index. So we have data coming from Filebit, Metricbit, Packetbit, and Earthbit here. So what I want to look at is at this common field. I know that there is a host.name field within the ECS specification. I want to know where I can find information about this host.name field, in the indices that I have. So here I can see that Metricbit, Packetbit, and Filebit are generating this this field. So let's have a look in more details about the events that have been collected. So I'm just going to look at the host part of the event, not everything, because the ECS specification and the Metricbit and Packetbit and Filebit are containing a lot of data. So here I can see that for the host field, I have over values, which are all parts of the ECS specification. But here I can see that I have my host.ip, which is an array, and this array contains IP addresses. It can be IP version 4, IP version 6, and this is what I have. So here this is this IP address. And if we look at Packetbit, this is also the same IP address that I have within the same field name. And same for Filebit, but now this is another IP address that we have. So let's go back to the logs that I mentioned before. If we look at the logs that we are collecting with Filebit within the last 5 minutes, I can see that I have logs coming from access.log, syslog, and outlog. How I can know that? Because, again, we are following the specification, and when we want to store the path to the log, we store that in this field, log.file.path, whatever the source of the data is. So this is super consistent. One thing we are missing here is the logs from our application. So we don't have any logs from the application. It's because I did not start yet the application. Oops. Actually, it was running. Oh, yes. It was running, but I did not do anything. So let's start it again. Okay. So now it's generating logs. And this log is using the logback ECS encoder that we saw. This is also generating the logs as JSON documents, but those logs are following the ECS specification. So if we go back again here, to here, I can see that now I have my 14 events coming from this log. And if I look at the logs itself, I can see that we have this message that has been collected here. And because we follow the specification, we know that all the logs are going to write the content within the message field. And we can see all the other information, like, again, the host and the IP address of the host, as we saw previously. So because all that is common and we follow that specification, we can actually go to other application like the logs application. I'm not going to enter in details about the logs application. This is not the purpose here. But what we can see, we have all those logs coming. And because everything is common, I can actually narrow down the content and search, for example, all the logs in my Spring Boot Reactive demo, for example. And here I can see all the information that I am expecting, all the logs from this application. So everything is standard. And this is the important thing to recall. So let's have a look at the reference guide. So the reference guide contains all the information that you need. For example, the SAS field reference. Again, if I go to the host fields, here I can have the whole description for the different fields that we are using. What is super interesting is that we are trying, for example, for this field, for host CPU usage, we are trying to use the best Elasticsearch types that we can apply to this field. So you don't have to think about that. If I go back here, there is also an important categorization field. And here, for example, for this event.outcome field, we can see that we can have only three values, which are failure, success, or unknown. If you don't have one of those values, then you are not compliant with the ECS format. So if you build something, please read the documentation and be compliant. If you go to additional information, you will have an access to the guide on how to contribute to ECS and also the generated artifact. So when you go to the ECS GitHub repository, you have access here to the schema. This is where you can contribute your change. For example, if I go here to the host again, there is a host YAML file which describes all the fields and probably the IP address, which is here. And so here, this is where we are describing the ECS specification. From that specification, we are able to generate data. And this is super interesting to see. So all the fields for bits, for example, the fields in CSV format. So if you want to import that in your application to do whatever, then you can do that as well. And also what I found interesting is this Elasticsearch directory here, where you can see the component templates that are going to be applied to Elasticsearch anytime you want to use the ECS format. So for example, here for the host again, if I look at the component template for the IP address, I can see that the type that we defined for this IP address is an IP type of field. With that, we can be super consistent, whatever the source of the document that we are collecting, the event we are collecting. So every single integration that we have here are using this ECS format. That's all what I have for today. Thank you, and see you tomorrow for a session about APM. Goodbye.